Hello again, this is Ruben for Sonic Kinetic, and in this tutorial video I'll be taking a good look at the Capriccio Runs patch. If you haven't already, please take a look at the Capriccio overview and the in detail videos to familiarise yourself with how the Capriccio engine works. The Runs instrument operates in a very similar way to the other Capriccio patches, with a few unique features. So let's get to it. The interface is easy to use, and for the most part the same as the other Capriccio patches. There are four presets, which have two fields each. And each field can be assigned to either strings or woods, so that you can have all woods, all strings, or a combination of both. You open the phrase picker here to choose your wind or string runs, which are represented by the graphics, just to show you the length and the style of the run. Strings are here, woodwinds just here. The phrase lengths range from 4 beats, the long ones here, to just 1. And you can preview the runs in the normal way just by clicking on the little speaker icon. The phrases with the blurry horizontal line here are phrases that start on the 5th interval. You can hear the difference. The woodwinds have two variations for each phrase, and they can be selected here. And with this key switch activated, the engine will cycle between them. You can turn that off as well. Within the fields, there are the usual Capriccio options for purging the samples, mute and unmute, the volume controls, and the speed controls. The score view is also the same, and you can export the MIDI in the same way, just by dragging to your DAW. To learn more about Drag MIDI, please take a look at the extras video. And for a handy reference of all of the features, just click the information button here, and you'll get a useful overlay for easy reference. So, to the runs. Because of the nature of the material, and because the runs are not looped and will usually be used just as one-shot samples, the runs patch is operated in a slightly different way than the regular Capriccio patches. So you still play a major or minor triad on the blue keys just here, but this time you'll not hear the samples play straight away. So playing this triad just cues up the engine so that it knows which major or minor run to play next. To actually trigger a run, you press one of the preset buttons from G-sharp 4 to B-sharp 4. This method of triggering the runs means you can play one run and cue up another one with a different chord quite quickly, and it makes the runs patch work in conjunction with the other Capriccio patches in the same contact instance, where the engine will always pick up the chord automatically. You can also use the harmonic shift keys to play major and minor intervals relative to the root chord in the same way as the regular Capriccio patches. So let's cue up C major and try some different harmonic intervals. Hopefully you get the idea. You can set up the harmonic shift matrix in the normal way and set the intervals to major or minor, or just a default. The nice thing about this approach is that it will always play runs that fit in with the key of your piece, so you could set your chord to the main key of your piece, and the notes in the runs you trigger with harmonic shift will adhere to that key. So far we've just heard runs of the same length, but you may have runs of different lengths selected, for example here. The intelligent engine will combine the runs so that they sound natural together, mixing the ascending and descending parts of the run in unison. So you can hear how this works especially well if I just set the panning to hard left and hard right of these two different runs. You've got a short string run and a longer woods run, and the string run, instead of being played at the end of the 4-beat phrase, will actually be played in the middle, so that the ascending and descending parts fit together. Let's have another example, this time with two woodwind runs. This one is 3 beats long, and this one is shorter at just 2. You can hear there how they end together. The other features of the options menu work in exactly the same way to the other Capriccio patches, including volume, pan, microphone, tuning, and crossfade is similar, but this control will actually dictate the release time of the sample. For more information about Capriccio, please take a look at our other videos, or head to the Sonic Kinetic website at www.sonickinetic.net. Until next time.